here now with my buddy KELE OKEREKE of Bloc party fame. Yay!
Hello!
How are you doing today?
I'm doing good, how are you doing today?
Relaxing your shorts?
Yeah, well, you know, it's hot. I don't know if all the viewers won't be able to tell, but it's a real hot day in Vienna today, isn't it? I've actually been doing some producing. That's what I've kind of been doing, a bit of working with other singers and, you know, just trying my hand at that. And it's something I've been really enjoying because I've been DJing so much in the last, like, 3 years. And, you know, I think I would quite like to explore that for a while, you know, just, you know, have some fun at being creative and it not be about my personality, about, you know, being somebody else's. Writing a collection of short stories, and I finished them and I kind of got very far. But you know, the thing that's exciting me the most at the moment is an idea I've been having about an actual novel. I think that would be a more sensible thing to devote time to. I have the idea now of what the novel will be about. So when we get some actual time off, I'm gonna sit down and you know, clear off a year and just do it.
You've also written for The Guardian?
I wrote an article for The Guardian, yeah.
That was recently. About Kelly Rowland breaking down on Beyonce.
Yeah, for sure.
You kind of basically said that she should just sort of get on with it.
Yeah, I mean, you know, I think it's a human trait, isn't it, to compare yourself to people that might be more successful than you. In any particular field, but I think the thing to bear in mind is everyone's on their own journey, and you know you should never get faint-hearted, and you should always remind yourself that you know it could be worse, your situation could be worse. I know at times I am lost, I am gone, I am cold, I'm only half there. But you were there in my thoughts, in my head, in my heart, above the left side. I know the time for us has passed, but you must know one thing.
How did it sort of treat you? How did you experience it?
Yeah.
As in general and sort of the music scene as well?
I mean, I didn't really do much exploring in the music scene, really. That was kind of the point about going to New York. It was about just getting away from everything. Although I did, you know, go to clubs, you know, occasionally, and that was, you know, and that was, I guess, important for my understanding of kind of dance music. But no, I didn't really, I wasn't checking out the hot new bands or anything like that. It was a strange time for me because, as I was saying, I was there for a year and I wasn't really working, I was just like writing and, well, just waking up and going for walks and exercising and meditating and going out, you know, I didn't have to get up and do a job, and you know, but conversely, everybody that I met there in New York was working like really hard. They were working long days or two jobs, you know, just to survive, you know, because it's a very hard city to live in. You have to, if you don't have money, it's a hard city to live in, and you know, so I was constantly meeting all these kind of stressed, anxious people, but I was the most relaxed I'd ever been, so it was a kind of a strange, I felt kind of slightly out of step, but I'm very glad that I saw it, you know. Yeah.
Do you think it's harder than London?
I don't think so. I mean, I've lived in London all my life, so, you know, I know where to go and who to go there with and who not to go there with, you know. I know whose hand not to shake and what not to do, whereas in New York it was really like, I was just meeting lots and lots of strangers. I had no kind of reference, you know. I didn't tell them about what it was I was doing, you know, or what it was I did. I wanted to experience just normal life, you know, the way that I did before all this kind of happened. You know, you get to go out and have fun, and it's not an issue, you know. No, you know, you're not worrying about someone's camera phone, or, you know, you get to just experience leisure time in the way that everybody else does, and that was quite nice to have that back again. There's a voice in my head that I probably should have trusted from the start. From the start, I finally flipped out and I'm hiring a detective.
Yes. How's that? Why did you come back?
I felt like I'd seen what I wanted to see, and it was time to go home. I'm quite excited now, actually, for this last week of touring, because after that, you know, we're done for like a while, and I've no plans to travel, so I'm going to be in. I'm going to be in South London. I'm going to be at home for like a few months, definitely for the duration of the summer, and I want to feel that. I want to go cycling. And I want to wear like shorts and sandals and just enjoy life for a bit, yeah, for a while. Being creative, do some DJing, just, you know, I just want to live my life, you know, I just want to live my life. You know, there are no concrete plans of yet, but I'm sure there'll be people will be seeing a bit more of me next year.
I'm
Well, in that case, we're done.
We're done. We are
so,
done.
So, that was fun. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hug time.
Hug time.
I'm gonna get hug time. You just don't want to show your legs. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. I'm really good time. Cheers.
Cheers.
Cut it out.